Hey guys, I'm Papa Pete, back with a different type of video today. Today's video is about the Mattel Intellivision. And if you've watched my videos in the past, you know how much I love the system. There's some of my favorite pickups to get. I'm looking forward to the Amico coming out. And I'm just trying to get all the 125 games. Speaking of that, don't forget my series, the 125, featuring each and every one of the 125 different games released for the Mattel Intellivision between 1979 and 1989. Anyway, but it's a 40-year-old system, so it's really kind of hard to find the games. So I thought I'd do a quick video that says 5 different ways that I think you could try to find Intellivision games today. You want to add to your collection? Follow my lead. Here we go.
Papa Pete, Papa Pete, the old ass gamer.
Papa Pete, the old ass gamer.
If you haven't grown up by the age of 50, you don't have to.
Now some of these ways are really kind of common sense, but they're still effective even in this day and age. And that gets me to my very first one that I want to mention, and that is garage sales, yard sales, and thrift shops. You never know when you're going to find Intellivision games. You really got to look sort of in the corners, but the problem is, more and more as these games get older and older, they're getting out of the closets and such. Really, a lot of them have already been brought out. And I myself haven't had a lot of success in finding games at yard sales in this area, but I have heard about people finding things. And, you know, it's when you do, you usually have a very great find. You can find some absolutely amazing things there, some amazing games. But, you know, at the end of the day, I would say as far as thrift shops go, or yard sales, garage sales, I always keep my eye out for Intellivision. Do I usually find a lot of the newer stuff? Just because of the age and of different systems, yeah, you see all kinds of Wii, 360, even some newer stuff than that. But I don't see much Intellivision or even old Atari. But still, if you can find the stuff there, you gotta always be on the lookout, because you never know when you're gonna find that gem. Now the next place that I'd recommend looking for Intellivision games of all types are at either retro game stores or maybe at conventions. If you have any conventions in your local area, they're even really worth traveling for quite a bit. I know that the main convention that I've gone to over the years has been Too Many Games in Philadelphia, and it's about a 15-hour drive for us. But we make a weekend of it, we really enjoy it, and we take advantage of it while we're there. Now, with retro game stores, it's sort of the same thing with garage sales and yard sales. These games haven't been as popular the last few years. They sort of gone by their biggest popularity. And I really find that anything pre-NES is not as common to find in these game stores. That being said, you do still see some commons, or if you happen to have an older collector like me who's really into these older systems, they might have a better selection. Although right now I am seeing an actual resurgence in Intellivision love with the upcoming Intellivision Amico in October 2020. But you can look online at different stores. They may have some. And at the conventions, I've always had some luck finding some stuff, some Intellivision stuff at these conventions at Too Many Games. But of course, the amount of it there is just far, far outweighed by the newer stuff like your Xbox, your NES, your PS2, PS3. All that stuff is everywhere. And you're just looking for the half dozen places that might have some Intellivision stuff. And if you get real steel, I consider myself pretty lucky. Now the third place that I look for Intellivision games is on Facebook or online groups, and that's buy and sells. Like, look for the games in your local buy and sells, because they're sort of like the yard sales and garage sales. They're tucked away in somebody's closet. Maybe there's an absolute steal somewhere to be had. There's nothing wrong with being in these local Facebook groups and putting in your requests, saying, "Hey, I'm looking for Intellivision," or something like that, and people might know what they are, realize, "Hey, it's in the closet. I can make $50 off it," and you get a real steal that way. But probably more common with Facebook groups are groups that are especially dedicated to the Intellivision. You got places like Intellivision Invasion. You have other ones like Intellivision Retro Games Buy and Sellers. Two or three different ones I'll show you a few here on the screen. They're great spots to go. There's people that are collectors of the Intellivision, and you can get some really good deals there. You will get some of the more difficult games to find, but really what you can do is you can use it to buy a lot of the commons that you might need, because people, of course, buy bundles, so they have a lot laying around. And overall, I just say it's a good spot to communicate, get tips, and you really will have a good time linking up to find different Intellivision games for your collection. Now, the fourth place I'm going to tell you is a place that I look at a lot. I've talked about this in a lot of my pickup videos, that where I live, there's not a lot of stores. There's not a lot of even thrift stores around here. And the yard sale, garage sale, it's very small in this area. It's not a very populated area. So I use a lot of eBay. And you can't argue about eBay. If you're going to find something, you can find almost anything you're looking for on eBay. But you're taking a chance when you do it. I find eBay to be quite expensive now. It's getting more and more expensive all the time. And people are getting into it that are generic sellers who have games and such and really don't know what the value is. You'll see games on there that you know might be worth $10, and for whatever reason, because it's a little bit different, you'll have a seller that'll have it on there for like $70. The pricing on eBay nowadays is from one extreme, I'd say, to the other, but no, it tends to be for an amount that I might be willing to pay up to some extreme amount that there's no friggin' way that I pay. It's gone overboard. Now, a lot of my games that I picked up in the 2000s to build my collection back up from when I was a kid, I had like 40 original games, 40 to 50 original games, but a lot of the other games which we didn't have when I was younger, I picked them up through the 2000s, and I picked them up very cheap too. Now, lately, that's just not even possible. Yes, you can still get your Major League Baseballs for under $10, although they used to be two. You can get your Armor Battles for $5. But to find these other games, the prices have just gone through the roof. And the thing about it is the people who are selling them really aren't that educated about the game. They just see the raw number, they don't judge the condition, and it's really a bit of a crapshoot to go with eBay. Can you find what you're looking for, what you need? Yes, but I consider it chancy, and I consider it really overpaying quite a bit. All right, I got some company now. I got Treacle visiting, sitting in her basket. The fifth and final place that I want to tell you about where you could pick up Intellivision games is very, very new, actually. But it's coming, and it's been created from somebody who's very well respected and has a long history in the different Facebook groups buying and selling games. And that is a website that was just created called IntellivisionCollector.com. Now, IntellivisionCollector.com, as it says right on the webpage, was created by Intellivision fans, by Mr. Luke Boudreau, who is actually one of the most prolific sellers of Intellivision games on Facebook groups over the last few years. He's known for picking up great lots and being able to get great titles and selling them for fair prices according to the condition that they're in. Very highly respected seller who has now taken the time to create his own website with all kinds of different games. You can get used games, you can get sealed games, you can get just the carts if you want. You're going to be able to get different items, like if you want just boxes or manuals or overlays, different parts of the system. You got ECSs on there, you got Intellivision 1s, 2s. I'm sure if he gets other ones, they'll all be on this site. But the thing I like most about it, is that not only can you go to the site to look for the games that you need, but you can learn a lot from the site as well. He's got all kinds of different information on the variants that are out there for the Intellivision. And a lot of them I was quite surprised to see. I've noticed them before, but I've never seen them cataloged so well as they are on that site. So when you go to Intellivision Collector, you're finding out about all the different variants. You're able to go to that site to do some research, to take a look at your own collection to see exactly what you have. And I'm going through mine right now. I'm not going to start collecting a whole bunch of variants until possibly if I should ever get to the 125, but I really am going to use that site. I'm going to find games that I need, but I'm also going to learn a lot about the Intellivision system. Now, Luke's been selling games forever, like I said, on Intellivision Invasion, and if you go onto that site, you'll get all kinds of references, so check that out. It's actually quite amazing. And a matter of fact, he's going to be selling some homebrews as well. Some of the larger, I don't know if you're into the homebrew scene or not, but if you aren't, you should be, because there's some really interesting games out there to look at. But one of the difficulties with the homebrews is These guys who create the games are also trying to do the marketing and selling and production and such like that. Well, what Luke is looking at doing, he's looking at getting agreements with these different game creators, like Electro Knight, for example, would be one, and selling their games for them from his Intellivision Collector site, which is really a great thing because it's one-stop shopping for Intellivision games. There really isn't anything online right now completely and strictly dedicated to the Intellivision, so I really think you should check that one out. IntellivisionCollector.com. You'll be glad you did. Well, guys, that's it for today's video. Different ways you could find those Intellivision games to add to your collection. Man, they're so old, it's hard to do nowadays. Garage sales, yard sales, there aren't many out there anymore, but if you do, you're going to get some great finds. You got eBay, you got Facebook groups, you got thrift stores. I think I found one or two games ever at a thrift store, or go to IntellivisionCollector.com. It's really got tons of information, and I'm sure you're going to find something you're looking for. Anyway, guys, thanks for spending a little bit of time with me today. Don't forget to hit like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Take care.
Hey, it's Paul Nermanen, or Nermix, from the Intellivisionaries podcast. I'm also part of the Amico development team, and you're watching Papa Pete, the Old Guy Gamer. What the hell?